guys, Jimmy or Chaos, welcome back. And as promised, I told you guys I would take you on a trip through my armory, show you my gear, my elite weapons, stuff like that. So I'm going to do that. And if you guys want to see another supply drop opening pretty soon, let me know. I can do that. I probably have 10 saved up so far. And I've got them recorded and stuff, so I can build you guys another one of those. That seems to be a popular type video for you guys as well. But let's jump into the armory. I'm gonna show you guys what I have. If there is anything specific in here you'd like to see me or see me do a video on, you can let me know in the comment section or on Twitter. So let's jump right into this. We're gonna go through each page. We're gonna go pretty quick, but I am gonna show you guys some of the cool stuff. So I have some of the best, I have the best AK-12 guns that you can get. I've got the Wrecker, which actually isn't a bad gun at all. You lose accuracy, which you can gain back with some attachments, but you gain 2 handling on it. Then we have the infamous RIP, which is my favorite gun right now in Advanced Warfare. And as you can see, you have 1 increase on damage, 2 on accuracy, and all you're giving up is 1 on mobility, which is not that big a deal to me, because I'm going to throw on a red dot, probably a grip or a dual mag. I'm going to up some more of these stats with this thing, so it turns out to be a beast. And the other one is the finger trap. And this one, you don't lose anything at all. You gain 3 handling on this bad boy, which is just insane. And both elite versions have the old school AK half moon sights, and you can't go wrong with them. Next, we've got an elite Atlas 45 Oathbreaker, which I haven't tried yet. The BAL 27223, the BAL 27.308, which this is actually a really good gun as well. Well, depends on the patch, depends on what's going on with the BAL for next gen, but I've used this gun a lot. I have not used the PDW Chucker yet. You lose a lot of categories you go down in, but you gain 3 on your fire rate with this thing. So I'm assuming the word chucker means it chucks even more bullets out. The MK14 Eagle Eye, I have not messed with that gun. The Maz Ignition, haven't messed with that. I use this gun a lot. The IMR Hushed with the integrated silencer on it. I like this. I don't mind that it loses 1 handling. Like I said, I'm big on attachments, so I'm going to boost my stats up with certain attachments that I want to use. And then the feedback, which I have not used yet, but I probably will. And then we have the Elite MDL Shockwave, which this gun is, the Shockwave, or the MDL is crap as far as I'm concerned. Page 2, we'll start at the bottom. The Pytec Loophole, I believe I've done a video on this one. The Methodic, which is a professional, and the LR, which is an enlisted. The SAC-3 Misery and Company and the Crime and Punishment. You guys can see the different stats. The fire rate is 18 on that one. Pretty cool. I'm not really big on this gun at all. I don't have any elites of it yet either. The EP M3 Parsec. It is maxed out with range. You don't lose anything. I'm going to assume this is the best version of this gun, because there are no negatives. You don't have any red losing any points. You gain 3 in range, which maxes it out. The handling sucks, but that's got to be the best version of that gun. The AMR-9 Dynamo, which I have used before. There's a whole lot going on with this thing. Every category goes up or down except for 1. As you can see, this is a SMG 5 burst. And let's see here. Did it have any? No underbarrel attachments. The EM-1 Quantum, which a lot of people are saying the EM-1 is the gun to go with now. There's nothing done with this stat-wise. It's just got the brass finish or gold finish. This was one of those digital or pre-order or whatever, but I'm going to give it a try anyway with probably stock foregrip and a red dot and see what that does. KF5 Locomotive, you're gaining some mobility, losing some fire rate. Then we have the Average Joe HBR, the Raider HBR, and then the KF5 Genuine. Moving right along, we've got the Atlas 20mm Presto, which looks like a very solid gun for a professional version. There is no negatives to it. It just goes up 2 in fire rate. The RW1 Rail Driver, which is a very pretty gun. And the NA45 Screaming Elite version of that sniper rifle. We've got the Ameli Spacer Subverter. We've got 2 spacers. Let's go ahead and cash that bad boy in for 1,000 XP. We don't need to worry about that anymore. The Crossbow Righteous, which I used in my Hunger Games class. The Ameli Elite Chicanery, which we can't see stats yet for, or the Whale Horn. And then we have the Atlas 20mm Hypersonic. Down here, we've got some of our pistols. We've got the BAL, the Atlas. Then we have the Crossbow, the Black Ops 2 version. We are on to page 4. We got some Orbital Pants, Assassin Pants, Leader Pants, Rebel shirt, Recon, you guys get the gist. I like this one, though. The Sentinel Operator shirt's pretty cool. Assassin jacket, Airborne jacket. This is one of my favorite ones as well. The AK-12G, which is the Ghost version. The Vigilante shirt and the Recon shirt. Page 5, more Airborne pants. Just tons of pants. I like that mask. I love this mask. Don't really care about the bandana. Not bad on this one. I'm trying to hold on to a lot of this gear when it comes to the clothing and mask because I want to try to get any of these custom class setup videos. I'm trying to utilize everything I can to make it as close as I can to whatever character we are doing. There's you some more helmets. I don't like that one. Airborne helmet. KVA assassin mask. Nigerian armored helmet. There's an elite helmet. And an Atlas tier 1 helmet. I believe I got that one. I prestiged. That one's pretty cool. Bloodshed. Just tons of helmets. I like that one. That's probably going to be my Halo class if I ever do one. That's the closest thing I have to a Halo helmet. And that one's really weird because you can actually see the dude's face. If they would have covered in that face hole with like this, with that kind of red lens, that helmet would be badass. And there, that's my favorite helmet. My Sentinel Elite Operator helmet. I love that one. And then we have some loadouts. I got a couple elites here. There's Mercenary. As you guys can see, Sentinel Operator loadout. That's a cool one. I like that one. It's got like an Ace of Spades on it. Nigerian Sentinel Medic. And I love this Marksman loadout as well. That's one of my favorites. And we have some gloves, some knee pads. Nothing special here. We got some zombie stuff. You see, I like those shin guards. Maelstrom shin guards. And Atlas Recon knee pads. Nothing special here. Super special, but still pretty cool. Got my royalty gloves. Got my Mountain Dew gloves. Got my zombie gloves. I have some nice gloves. Assassin gloves. Airborne leader gloves. And we have some boots, which I'm not really worried about that much. And we're getting to the end here. The Career XO. I have two of those, and I can't get rid of them, which is weird. Elite Sentinel Airborne. I like that one. I really like the Radical Elite. I've got the Advanced Arsenal, the Assassin, the Marine Expeditionary XO. I'm not really big on that one. This one is super clean looking. And this one is too, the Vigilante. Some more boots and then the Sentinel Recon XO. And on the last page, we have some radar imaging glasses, the Zombie XO, the Scout XO, which is cool. Some Canteen sunglasses, an MK14 Deluxe, and an AK-12 Competition. And the Nigerian Command loadout. So there you go, guys. That is my armory as of right now. Maybe I'll do one in the future. I take stuff and get rid of stuff. I'm trying to end up with all elite stuff unless there's a couple special things I like that aren't. Drop a like on the video if you would. Hope you guys enjoy it. Let me know what's in your armory and what you'd like to see out of this armory from me in future videos. You guys have a great day. I'll see you later.